He had a guy bearing down on him, and he held in and made the throw. Is that the kind of play he could have made 4 weeks ago, or does that show his development?
I think he could have. I mean, I'd like to credit on development, but I don't think Jake Fromm's worried about somebody barreling down on him. He's a tough kid, a physical kid. I think he can make those plays. He's going to have to in this league because that's what this league's about. They're going to have people. They have pass rushers in this league.
What are your thoughts about Dominic passing you for career interceptions?
Proud of Dominic. It took you a long time.
How do you feel about the balance? How do you feel about the balance tonight? I mean, you're not going to get any more balance than you were. What was 203 and 201?
You could get a little more balance. They did a good job mixing it up. I thought they had them all balanced. You know, you were seeing Todd after the game. It was probably tough on him because it was hit or miss. You know, we hit some calls against right calls for him. And it was tough. So we mixed it up good. And I think when the quarterback's throwing the ball and completing passes, I think that makes it easier. But look, guys, I know every one of y'all wants to write how great this was and how good it was. We still got drop balls. We still got missed blocks. We still got missed tackles. We still got a lot of room for improvement. We got a team that's got to go on the road this week, just like Mississippi State had to this week after a big win.
How much of the offensive success tonight do you put on the game called by Jim or the fact that Jake is now four games in?
Well, I don't give credit to anybody. It's a team effort. I mean, you know, I mean, you could say it's Jim, you could say it's Jake, you could say it's O-line receivers. I mean, it's a total team effort. I thought the game plan was very clear, very concise. I'm still rewarded to do. But what makes a game plan work is the people out there doing it. You know, the first couple runs where we got 4 or 5 yards, we were like, hey, this is what we thought we could do. Let's go do it. Let's stay aggressive. And I thought Jim did a good job calling the game.
Could Easton have played tonight if you needed him?
He could not have played tonight. He wasn't technically cleared.
Coach, in regards to Nate Chubb and that wild love formation and the touchdown run that he had, I mean, what kind of led to that hole being open there? And I mean, how does that sort of play kind of set itself?
I think that play, if everybody goes back and watches it, I keep telling y'all, nobody gives the guy the credit. Number two, Jason Stanley, takes a guy and ear holes him and knocks him 5 yards the other way. And nobody gives Jason Stanley credit. But Jason Stanley had a big time block on that play. Isaiah Wynn did, and it was just like we practiced. It was creased. And that was a design play by Jim, who said he thought it would work, and he had a good play call there. It was really aggressive. And it was a good call, good design, and good execution. When you get all three of those, you got a chance.
Coach, the players said that you sort of mentioned that Dom had tied you in interceptions in the locker after the game. Why did you feel the need to do that? Why did you want to do that?
Because I try to give all the guys an award or accolade after the game, and I felt it was valuable to him and Dom's confidence. He's a kid that thrives on the interceptions, and he's been a great leader. You know, every game we've had, Dom's been willing to stand up and speak to the team. Wanted to give him some recognition, which I thought was great. Had nothing to do with me, I promise you that.
Where did you get that idea, Coach? Where did you to give each one of the players the accolade or the award? Where did that come from?
That just comes from those guys doing hard work. I mean, I've been around it before where you got to give credit to the guys who work hard and play well. And Rodrigo and Cam, again, just continue to be very consistent. And we talk about each guy in there in the locker room afterwards.
Was there a coach you learned that from, though? Like, that you emulate?
Are you asking, did Nick ever do that?
you play for other coaches.
I really don't remember anybody ever doing that.
Something you started?
I didn't invent it. I've been doing that for years. It's hard to do that because you got to be careful. You don't know what really happens sometimes. Sometimes you can be saying something and not be right.
Kirby, you mentioned Jim with play calling. How about as a quarterback's coach dealing with starting freshman quarterback 2 years in a row? How does he handle that?
Like a champ. He didn't complain to me. I complain to my wife all the time about it, but it doesn't do any good. You know what I mean? There's nothing you can do about it but go with it. Bottom line is that's why you recruit. I mean, you recruit to go find players because you want to have the best players. They do the same thing at every level. I mean, same thing in health business, right? I mean, you're constantly trying to find the best. That's what we're trying to do, so we want to play the best. And luckily, we were able to get this kid to come in here because where would we be without him, you know?
Kirby, the expectations for Georgia are going to be that much higher. So what do you do to try to temper that?
We have difficult practices. You don't temper that. You just got to do a good job managing your team. And if you have a mature team, they handle things like that well. It does concern me because I worry about those guys reading and believing it, you know. But I was around a guy for 10 years that did a good job managing.
Kirby, has Isaac Nauta improved his practice habits and is that reflected in his play tonight?
No comment. Isaac continues to improve. We'll keep working with Isaac and he'll keep doing the things he's got to do. I'm glad that he is able to make the play that he made.
What did you think of that whole scenario with if Bellamy gets, if that Tarvin stands up, you got an issue next week?
Yeah, not much I can do. You know, it's out of my hands and it's hard because, you know, LSU had like two like that, maybe three, and, you know, it's frustrating because you can't coach a player. I mean, I really don't think Davin had the intent of doing that. What do? You take off the aggression of a defensive player rushing the passer. Can't do that. We had talked all week about the D word, discipline. We thought it cost LSU. We showed the players two or three interviews of LSU players talking about discipline after the game. They didn't think they had it, and it cost them. So we showed them that, and to have that happen, I was really concerned, but good thing, I guess that made the right call. I never saw the replay, but it sounds like it wasn't.
Last question. The replay that Swift caught the ball, the stadium seems like his knee was down, the replay to see on the screen, but I guess
Those guys know what they're doing. I mean, they look at it. They're not trying to cheat. I mean, those guys look at it, they review it, see what it, they make the call. Appreciate it, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.